Good evening, basketball fans, and welcome to Hemeter Fieldhouse on the campus of Punahou School for day three of the 41st annual Punahou Invitational Basketball Tournament. I'm Mike Machado, and joining me this afternoon, former Punahou player and coach, Alan Lum. Alan, thanks for joining me.
Thanks for having me, Mike.
This promises to be a good one. Carver of Alabama and Wilson of Portland. Carver, the defending 6A Alabama state champion.
Yeah, we were talking earlier that they're very athletic and said that, you know, they've won a lot. You've talked to one of their coaches and they're used to winning, so they have that tradition behind them, and I think they're all business.
And you look at them, you can just tell there's some athletes there.
Definitely. I know you mentioned before that there are some guys who are being recruited not only for basketball but also football.
Yes, coach was telling me they're traditionally known as a basketball school, but this year they made it to the state semifinals in football, so it's high school, there are a lot of crossover athletes, so they're only three games into their season, so this is still, they're shaking off the rust a little bit.
Probably the jet lag too, traveling all from Alabama, but you know, they're no nonsense, all business. You know, we missed some of their representation in the slam dunk and shooting, three-point shooting last night, but I think the coach really wanted them to be prepared for what's at hand today.
You see number 15 getting ready to jump for Carver's, being recruited by Alabama and Mississippi State to play basketball. So there's some real D1 talent on the floor, and we are underway. Wolverines of Carver High School in Alabama and the Wilson High School Trojans of Portland, Oregon.
Wilson in a 2-3 zone, and Carver bringing it out to get organized.
You see Wilson really trying to collapse on Carver down low, and there you see Zach Rump from long range scoring the first points of the game.
I think in this situation, you have to pick your poison. I mean, you got to pack it in against his side, but if you go out and play man, you might get shredded, and there'll be some mismatches.
This Carver's center, number 52, Brandon Murphy, is also being recruited to play basketball by Ole Miss and Mississippi State. And there you see Ben Lynch with a three-point attempt. Bounces out. Rump bringing the ball up quickly. Back up top to Rump. He's thinking about the three. He's driving up and off the glass and one. Zach Rump.
Pretty amazing, the littlest guy on the court. You know, most effective. Hit a three. The guy come up to him and he goes right by him.
Thought I saw a bit of traffic in the lane. I didn't think he was going to do it, and he did.
Yeah, he did. He took that big step, kind of a Euro step, and got by the defender and trying to hit a traditional three-point play.
He drains it. Carver out to a quick 6-0 lead 1 minute into the contest.
You see pressure by Carver. I mean, they're very long. You got number 23 on the point. He makes it very difficult for the inbounder, and you got some quick guards at the wings, which are bigs in the back. It makes it very difficult for Wilson to even get the ball in.
Yes, most of Wilson's offense is going to be coming from number 10, Philip Black, number 14, Ben Lynch. Lynch is a sophomore. Both of them were in the three-point contest last night. Both of those guys have done the majority of scoring. Three-point attempt from Jack Rubin is no good.
It's funny because the ref called Carver ball, but it looked like it was blocked by Carver. But
a couple of the Wilson fans behind us think so too. There you see Austin thought about the three and then Rump with the three. They're going to call a foul underneath. Personal foul on number 52, Brandon Murphy of Carver. That's his first and the Wolverines' first team foul.
That's what Wilson has to do. They got to play position and box out. It's a lot harder in the zone.
Casey Lynch. Working around outside to Blatt. Out top to Stock. Back to Lynch. Trying to dump it down low. Against this big and physical Carver team. Everybody on the floor for Carver is big and long now.
I know.
Rubin thinking about the three again. Stock down low, wants to get the shot off. He's stripped by Houston. Carver on the break, they pull it up. Rump thinking about the three. Jarrett takes the three. That bounces off the back iron, rebounded by Houston. He pulls up mid-range, drains it. Carver out, 8-0 lead.
Wilson had a pretty good offensive set last time, but didn't even get a shot off. A lot of patience. You know, this Hawaii tournament, no shot clock. These two teams are probably used to playing with a shot clock, so they have a shot clock in their mind.
It's kind of a natural rhythm as to how the play should evolve. See Stock being guarded outside to Blatt. Three-point attempt. Rims out. Rump pushing the ball up. Far side to Austin, to Rumpf, in the corner to Jarrett for three, drains it. Carver up to an 11-point lead, and Wilson's head coach, Scott Aker, has seen enough. 30-second timeout.
That's a great timeout call. You know, like I said, they got some bigs in there just plopped at the post, and they're stretching the defense by going baseline to baseline, and like you mentioned, Rumpf hitting that first three and then also taking it to the hole. It really spreads that offense, and the defense has difficulty covering baseline to baseline.
And as we said before, Wilson is going to have trouble matching up physically against this team. They're going to have to pick their poison, basically.
Definitely. I think, you know, they have to control tempo and, you know, use the shot non-shot clock as to their advantage. Maybe work the ball around a bit and see what they can do. But they need a bucket here badly.
And this game could get out of hand in a hurry. Carver applying some pressure. Rubin. Far side. Stock thinks about the shot. Back out to Slayton. Stock. Lynch and Blatt are the shooters. There's Blatt thinking about the three. Deed up by Rumpf. He's stripped. Here's Houston. Rumpf. Got Houston on the wing. He's going to the hole hard. Off the glass and in.
Nice strong move. Used his body, double pump, got the ball up on the glass.
See, Ruben, they're not careful. They're going to get called for a 10. They got to get this across. They're stuck. Near side to Ruben. Got Slayton in the corner, back out to Ruben. Lynch, long range, and he drains it. Wilson, a much needed 3-point basket from Ben Lynch.
And that might get them going. You know, I think you got to manufacture points, and you're not getting anything inside, so. Their outside game might have to take them.
And there's Jarrett with another three.
And it's matched. That's two in a row for number three.
Anthony Jarrett. As Lynch, he needs to get that across. Lynch was pretty much been their primary ball handler, what I've seen so far in this tournament. There's Ruben trying to find a cutting Blatt. It's knocked out of bounds by Carver. And you can see a couple subs for Wilson. Bailey Sadorf and number 12, Cole Conklin. And checking in for Carver, number one, Jeremy Johnson. Another one of the athletes we were talking about before. This young man's going to play quarterback at Auburn.
Nice.
That's Auburn.
Auburn.
In the SEC. Yeah, so he's probably a pretty good athlete, too.
I'm pretty sure he is.
Yeah. They find Lynch underneath, and he can't get it in.
He looked kind of intimidated by the size there. I think he had an easier shot.
Jarrett again. He draws nothing. Carver out to a 13-point lead. Houston trying to intercept. That will remain the Trojans' ball. We're almost 5 minutes in. It's 16-3 in favor of the Carver High School Wolverines. Game's not out of hand yet. Lynch thinking about the three. The Sadorf. Nope.
That's
Blatt.
Nice ball movement. Just can't hit it.
They just need some of these shots to go. At least now they're getting some looks. Shot outside to Austin. In and out. Rebounded by Slayton. Lynch pushing the ball up to Sadorf. Driving, trying to find Cole Conklin. Ball skates through. It'll be Carver ball.
I thought that was another one hit out by Carver. However, the officials see it differently.
Wow, some pretty colorful shoes on the floor. A lot of four of the Wilson players wearing pink shoes, and then you look at Jeremy Johnson's socks, number one for Carver. Black with stars on him. A number of the players showing some fashion sense.
I think it's the old RG3 thing where he wears all the different socks, maybe.
Yep.
If you dress like him, you'll play like him.
Who knows? He may.
He definitely may. what luxury to bring something off, you know, as that your sixth man, bringing off an athlete like that off the bench.
Well, Coach said they want him to play basketball too. He could play anything,
right.
Really. This round is Jarrett. Decides not to shoot. Jeremy Johnson boxed in the corner. Houston is fouled. Personal foul called on Cole Conklin for Wilson. That's going to be his first, the Trojans' first team foul.
I think Wilson's coach has to be happy. They're competing. You know, that was a tough foul, but they're competing.
They weathered that initial run. Now they just need some, they're getting some looks now at least. They just need the shots to drop.
Definitely.
Here's Austin deep to Jarrett. He turns.
Nice block.
Blocked by Matthew Slayton. Here's Rumpf again going to the hole, up and under. And there's Jeremy Johnson with the putback. Carver out to an 18-3 lead with 1:42 remaining in the first period, and that's stolen. Houston inside to Rumpf. Dish to Johnson off the glass. No good. Johnson gets his own rebound. This is going to call a travel. Checking into the game for Carver's number 25, Caleb Prophet. Ball's picked by Houston.
It's that length that they have. The pass looked like it was wide open, a cross court, middle pass where you want to beat the press, but the long arm just came out of there out of nowhere.
Demetrius Houston for three. Off the front rim, no good. Lynch with the rebound.
I think they got to run when they have the chance.
I think they're a little at all right now. they were making a lot of noise before the game. Here's Slayton down low. They're going to give him the and one. They do.
This is a really good test for the Wolfson Trojans, you know, going up size. They play in Oregon, but, you know, you go against a tough team like this, it's going to better you. See how your team does in the regular school year, and I think that's what a lot of the coaches do. They bring their teams out here not only for like a bonding experience, but also, you know, what can we do against different talent?
Right, because you're so used to seeing the same people all year round. I mean, even in club ball. That was Blatt with a shot, no good. Johnson going the length of the floor, hits the front rim, no good. Rebounded by Houston. That's out of bounds to the Trojans.
Great effort on the offensive board by the Carver team. The tough part for the Trojans is that they get the ball, but now they got to face their press.
There's Lynch. He's trapped. Calls a timeout. Saves the possession. So they're down 2 of 5 timeouts now in 7 minutes and 15 seconds. It's a 30. So Wilson's burned both their 30s already.
Maybe they think they have a TV timeout or a webcast timeout.
Wouldn't it be nice?
It would have been.
But hey, we're happy to be here. The Wilson's road to this point in the tournament has been a little tighter than Carver's. They got by Mililani 56-41 in the first round and then had a tough one against King Kekalike of Maui yesterday, just escaping with a 41-39 victory. Very hotly contested match. Then Carver's had a little easier road, 66-39 on the first day over St. Francis. And then yesterday, beat the number one, according to the polls, beat Mary Knoll by 30. 62-32 on Mary Knoll's home floor.
Well, that's a good test for them.
Right. See Johnson going hard at the basket, and he's getting the and one. Austin Blatt was doing what he could, but keeping the big body of Jeremy Johnson out of the
I think he scored 2 points and got the first down on that, too.
I think so. Let's see where they spot it. I think it was Blatt's first personal foul. Second team foul for the Trojans.
Very athletic.
It's a third team foul for the Trojans, excuse me.
You watch the Wilson coach, he's very, very supportive of his team and their effort thus far, even though the score doesn't indicate them doing anything positive. He's very positive with his players. I like that.
Well, what choice do you have at this point? You're down by 16 against a very good team. And here you see Austin, Brandon Austin on the breakaway. Shaquan Burkett trying to follow it up. That might have been some highlight reel footage.
Yeah.
Wilson was doing what they could to hold Brandon Austin up on the break.
Well, I thought if he knew his buddy was coming back, he might have thrown it off the backboard.
I think so.
Because his friend almost came and jammed it after that off that miss.
They call Thiessen for the foul on that. Right. 15 seconds remaining here in the first period. Carver up by a score of 21-5. Really putting it to Wilson. Austin drains the second one. Bad pass. Johnson steals the inbound pass. He goes to basket off the glass, and he'll be fouled. Just look at the way he moves. He's coming off the bench, Allen.
That's amazing. I mean, you know, he intercepted that pass. Maybe he should be a DB too. Maybe play both ways. But you saw that. That was an ill-advised pass by the Wilson player because he threw cross court past the backboard. It's a very long pass. He's almost baited by that great athlete.
You know, he handles the ball. I mean, he's got some handle. He's the biggest guy on the floor. Let's see what they can do to inbound here. Wilson manages to get it in. Austin Blatt to Lynch. He's going to have to get this across the timeline. 3 seconds. I don't know if they're going to get a shot off. They do from three. Bailey Sadorf with a three-point attempt. That's Nogan. We're at the end of the first period. Carver, 24-5 over the Wilson Trojans of Portland, Oregon. Wow.
Well, Wilson, they came off the court looking a little dejected, but I think they hustled. They have to understand that they're playing against guys who are way taller than them, and they're athletic. So they have to understand there's a process in their season. This is not their state championship. This is just a little, stay on their journey. Journey to Hawaii and maybe journey back to Oregon and maybe into their regular season. So I think they should just play this game, and I think coach is coaching the way he should be doing, putting him in situations that they may see later in the year, and the team will be better for it.
Find the teachable moments. I mean, they're losing by 19, but there's always going to be teachable moments, and you can't get down on the kids. You have to remember these are still boys.
Right.
These are still boys.
Well, you look at them, they haven't been on the beach. Usually a lot of times
No.
You see mainland teams, they're just sunburned. These guys have been resting. They've been focused. I think they've been enjoying themselves in Hawaii, but there's not too much sunshine also lately.
They look like they're from rainy Portland.
Right, so we made them feel like they're at home, right?
That's right. Of course, Carver coach said they got some beach time yesterday. There's Lynch being pressured by Caleb Prophet. Thiessen, Conklin, back to Sadorf.
Nice slip.
Down low to Conklin.
That was a nice slip pick. He should have shot the ball, but I think he is intimidated by the sides inside. Wilson is trying to use Carver's aggressiveness against them, trying to do a lot of backdoor.
Back up top to Conklin.
Gonna flash a high 1-4 and go back door.
Lynch, Sadorf, near side to Blatt. Thought about the three. He's fouled. They're gonna call Shaquan Burkett with a personal foul. Wolverine's third team foul.
It's amazing that they're so aggressive, but yet they're not fouling.
Down the bench, and they're going to call another. Of course, now that you say that.
Right.
It's another Carver foul on Caleb Prophet. His first fourth team foul for the Wolverines. Defending Alabama 6A high school champions. Lynch being guarded by Rumpf. Looking left, down low to Thiessen. Back outside to Conklin. Down low, Sadorf thinking about the shot, looking down low. It's bounced around. Conklin picks up the loose ball. See Sadorf battling. He gets it to roll in.
Nice blue-collar work by Sadorf. Kept at it, didn't give up.
So Jeremy Johnson on the wing. Long cross-court pass to Andre Ashley. Three-point attempt off the back of the iron. Looking low for Burkett.
They got to run.
Would Conklin go over and back?
It looked like it, but he didn't. It's a three-point.
Not. In a two-point game, you might get that call, not when you're up by 17. Yeah. See Rumpf taking his time. For Johnson at top of key, down low to Burkett, and he's fouled.
Nice interior passing there. You have to respect Rump's 3 points, so the two guys in the zone come out. Number one flashes to the middle and he gets an inside pass. So
Wilson making a number of subs. See Carver's Demetrius Houston. Houston and Johnson in the game at the same time. This will be interesting. Long inbound pass to Rumpf. So Jeremy Johnson, he's driving, pulls up from 13. No good, back of the iron. Burkett gets the put back. Carver up by 19, 6 minutes remaining in the first half. This is Rubin, cross-court pass. Sadorf, long range, no good.
Nice hustle by the Trojans.
That's stripped.
Turn it over, here's something.
Three on one, they're thinking about the dunk. They want it, Jeremy Johnson backs it in. Gets the shot, doesn't go. Wilson, personal foul. On Jack Rubin, that's his first. Seventh team foul for the Trojans. Carver's gonna be in the bonus for the next 5:49. Jeremy Johnson at the line shooting two. He just looked way too relaxed doing that, Alan.
He does.
Just.
Well, at Auburn, when the crowd's yelling, he has to call an audible. This will come in handy. Looks like he's in mid-season form for basketball. Probably got out of football.
And I think he's probably going to put another 20 or 30 pounds on that frame.
Oh, definitely.
See Conklin getting some pressure. Looking for Lynch. Looking for Rubin. Jeremy Johnson. Is he going to slam this down? Oh, he decides to lay it up and off the glass. He saw Lynch coming back. Didn't want to get cut. But you heard the whole crowd gasp.
Right.
They were waiting for Jeremy Johnson to do
Definitely.
Something spectacular. And I think we still may see it. Three on one. Alley-oop to Burkett. No. Johnson trying the alley. And here we I think we're still going to see it. Rubin still on the other end trying to knock it off the glass. No good. So much back and forth action. Rubin never had a chance to get back on defense.
Probably should have been a goaltend, too. He pinned it after the shot went up. I don't know if the outside official saw that. It was a goaltend.
They're going to call the personal foul on Zach Rumpf, his first Wolverines' fifth team foul, and Jack Rubin's going to be at the line shooting two. I'm going to go out on a limb here. I think we are going to see a couple dunks still yet in this game.
I'm pretty sure. But like a smart quarterback, he saw that linebacker come. He ran out of bounds, I think.
Right.
To get to self-preservation.
Keep the knees intact.
Definitely.
Just doesn't want to get cut.
There you go.
This Gus Malzahn, the new coach at football coach at Auburn, wouldn't want his
one
of his prize recruits to hurt his knee playing a hobby.
Yeah. It looks like eventually he might be in the starting lineup unless coaches want to bring him off as a sixth man.
You're
smart.
Houston drives. He draws the foul. On Matt Slayton, that's going to be his second. We'll see Demetrius Houston shooting two. Drains it. Carver out to a 22-point lead with 5 minutes remaining in the first half. What a pretty, haven't really been threatened so far.
No, they haven't. You know, they got up to that quick quick lead. And Wilson has come up.
They've had some looks.
Yes, they have. They're hesitant, you know.
Yeah, I think a little shell shock. We'll call Philip Blatt with the walk.
You know, when I coached against mainland teams, I told my guys, you have to compete because it's kind of like a boxing match. You get hit in the mouth once.
There it is. Demetrius Houston.
There you go.
Getting the oop end of the alley.
Wow. You get punched in the face, you got to come back and, you know, earn that respect. Don't be afraid of contact.
Wilson going hard the other end.
There's
Michael stopped the iron. Here's Demetrius Houston thinking about it. He gets fouled by Rubin on the way by. But they're still in the bonus. He's going to get shots.
50 got that oop, and he's like one of the smaller guys on the court.
That's Rubin's second personal. Ninth team foul for the Trojans. See Austin Blatt checking in. Some of the Carver fans making their loyalties known. See Stock bringing the ball up. Token pressure from Zach Rump. Content with their 24-point lead, they're calling off the press.
Maybe you have a good opportunity to work on their half-court offense, but you know that half-court press, they're still having difficulty getting the entry to the wing.
Philip Blatt looking for the inbound. Finds his brother Austin Blatt on the wing. Sador for three, and he drains it. Wilson hits double digits with just under 4 minutes remaining here in the second period.
I like Sador's game. Inside, outside, blue-collar guy, works hard.
And I'm certain he'll be very competitive in their league back home, but this Carver team is just something that they've never seen. And
just too many. You know, you can handle one or two, but when everybody's athletic, it makes it very difficult.
And they're 1-12. Bigger, stronger, faster. You know, you gotta. You know, it's easy to sit up here and say, you know, you just gotta go at them. But when you're out on the floor and you're looking at somebody, you know, on average, everybody's 5 inches, 4 or 5 inches taller than you. I mean, I may be exaggerating slightly, but.
But you know, what a great opportunity for Wilson to play a team like this. And you know, Carver right now, it looks like they're holding the ball, but I think they're just trying to work their offense.
Houston with a three-point attempt that rolls in and out. Rebounded by Austin Blatt. Mike Stock bringing the ball up. Guarded by Zach Rumpf. For Blatt at the top of the key for three. Back of the iron, no good. Rumpf pushing it up. Finds Murphy.
Great block. We had a follow on that.
Murphy with the putback.
So Carver attacks really hard.
And here they are with the press again. And they're going to call Demetrius Houston with the foul.
I think Wilson coach wanted his inbounder to run the sideline. That was kind of a long pass. If he ran the sideline, it would have been a shorter pass.
So Houston's going to take a seat. So he picks up his second. Carver with 16 fouls. So checking in for Wilson's number 15, Tyler Woodland. Also a good opportunity for the Wilson coach to work through his bench a little bit here.
Yeah, and I'm happy. You know, he's always coaching. He's right in front of us. He's always
staying positive.
Definitely. This is just one game along their whole schedule.
Up top to Black. Inside to Woodland, looking down low. Slayton tries a shot, and that's no good. Rump bringing ball up on the wing. We will call Dracon Murphy with the travel.
All you want to do is to have your team compete, and I think his team is competing. They haven't cashed it in. They're still working hard.
Because sometimes, I know you've seen this, games get the blows. You just see teams looking beat down once a margin gets up over 20. So it's a 23-point game now, 35-12, 1:46 remaining. They call a personal foul on Carver's Zach Rumpf. That's going to be his second. Now Wilson is in the bonus.
Well, Carver's style is a very aggressive style, so you know you hear the fans behind us yelling, hand check, and you know they are very, very physical on the hand check where they're funneling the ball through traps and things like that, so it makes it very difficult. And I don't know how it's called in Oregon or Alabama, but in Hawaii they're pretty, I think they're moderate on that, you know. Certain teams get away with it. Other teams don't. Depends on the maybe officiating crew.
Michael Stock hits his first, misses the second. Carver's ball with 1:46 remaining in the first half. Carver Wolverines out to a comfortable 35-13 lead. Here in the semifinals of the Punahou Invitational Basketball Tournament. A 16-team tournament this year, Alan.
It's a nice, nice size, you know. With Iolani's tournament down the way, I mean, this is a great opportunity for other schools that are not in to participate in a high-quality tournament.
A lot of quality basketball in town this week is the Iolani tournament, the Punahou tournament. And, of course, the Rainbow Classic.
Right?
It's the
Diamond Head Classic.
The Diamond Head Classic, yeah. Excuse me, apologies to the UH people.
But, we all remember it as the Rainbow Classic.
Right, Don Quixote's always going to be Holiday Mart to me.
Right, definitely.
But a lot of quality basketball for the Hoops fan this week in Hawaii.
I think you missed the one. Wasn't it Dae between Holiday Mart?
Yes, it was.
So
yes,
we missed one of those.
Of course, these references are totally lost on our mainland audiences.
Right.
Who will be watching this. Here we go. They can get that up. 3-on-none, and he safely bounces that off the glass. Charles Stanberry, excuse me. Their eyes all got big. The loose ball on the floor. 3-on-none.
They're probably defending each other. Who's going to get it? This high pressure is really tough to beat.
Stock happens. So they find Blatt at the top of the key for three, and he drains it. Philip Blatt. He's been Wilson's leading scorer to this point. He's got 14 points in each of their two games so far.
Well, he has a nice game. He screened for his point guard and rolled out. Kind of like the old Kevin Love play where they screen and roll your big man who can shoot out.
Yeah, 10 seconds remaining. Jarrett from three. Back of the iron. No good. Burkett gets the rebound. 3 seconds. Long range. And Caleb Prophet is no good. And we are at the half. The Carver High School Wolverines of Montgomery, Alabama, out to a comfortable 37-16 lead over the Wilson Trojans of Portland, Oregon. You know, saw the latter part of that first half, Wilson kind of calming down a little bit, getting some better looks at the shots, but it's still a 20-point game.
Yeah, well, we statted it. You know, a lot of times they didn't even get any shots off before they, got past half court. They either turned it over or, they had a violation out of bounds, but they need to get shots up, and that anything can happen. You get offensive rebounds. Just make sure you get a safety back,
Right, right. Well, we're going to take a little break. We'll be right back in a little bit with the second half, the Punahou Basketball Invitational Tournament. And welcome back. We're getting ready to start the second half here between the Wilson High School Trojans of Portland, Oregon, the GW Carver High School Wolverines visiting from Montgomery, Alabama. Carver out to a comfortable 37-16 lead in the first half. He really took it to Wilson in the early stages of that first quarter, Alan.
Yeah, they were very dominating. Their press and their athleticism, they got a lot of second shots, a lot of offensive rebounds. But, Wilson is upbeat. They're here for a reason. They're here to get better. I think if they have a good quarter, maybe they won't get back in the game, but, they get their self-esteem and their basketball playing back to where it should be, so when they go back home, they'll be set for regular season.
Right, because early on they looked a little shell-shocked. They looked a little shell-shocked, and then they started getting some looks, They weren't falling, and now they're starting to run their offense a little bit more.
It's just tough to handle the athleticism. I mean, that, you know, what a pass that may look open is not open now. But they're battling. That's the main thing. You want to teach effort, and they're, you know, the Wilson Trojans are showing effort, and that's all you ask as a coach at this point, trailing by that many points. The goal is to try to win the quarter. If they can win the quarter, that'd be nice. And that, you know, little steps here and there.
Yep, just remain competitive. With Coach Scott Aker, who's also the athletic director at Wilson, said before, finding those teachable moments. There's always going to be teachable moments.
Wonder how he's going to evaluate his coaching.
That's right. We're back to action in the third period. Carver Austin going to the hole. That's no good. Rebounded by Jarrett. Rumpf back to Jarrett. Thinking about the three. He's already drained a couple so far. We know he's got the range. He'd probably step back another 5 feet and drain it if he wanted to. There's Austin. And who's that? That was Jarrett among the trees down low.
Nice
the basket.
Nice baseline floater. I mean, he had a couple threes in the first half. Now they're coming out at him. He's going right by him, floaters.
And here you see Phillip Blatt on the wing. Nice pass down low.
They got to finish. Wilson got to finish. What a great look they had.
He should have. They should have finished that. Here's Jarrett. There he is with a three. Hoping for the foul on Blatt. Wilson looking to break. Blatt, no good. Kicks it back out. There you see Michael Stock trailing up and in.
Oh, that gave him some confidence. He didn't shy away. Everybody expected a big block, but I think he went up quick. Kind of a syncopated step. And now they scored early in the third quarter. Now they induced a turnover with an errant lob.
Jarrett provided the alley. They were looking for Brandon Austin on the oop. Pass was a little high. Here's Lynch from three, in and out. That's going to be off of Brandon Murphy. Wilson ball.
I think for Carver, they got to just shore things up. And you got the lead. They'll probably win this game, but they just have to play clean basketball, execute what they want to do. I think that's what their coach would want them to do.
Lynch on the wing. On a foul the other way. Calling Matthew Slayton with the push down low. That's going to be his third personal foul. Can't imagine the Wilson coach would be real worried about the foul totals in this. This game's a teaching experience.
Yeah, definitely. I think, you know, he's just been tired of being pushed around. He just got to probably push back, but that might help him in the long run.
Give him a little confidence. You see Houston on the wing looking down low. Ooh, looking for Brandon Murphy down low. Then you see the follow-up. Carver showing off some of the athleticism. They call a personal foul.
I think that might be his fourth.
I believe so. Call that on. Is that on Slayton?
I think he's subbing him now, 32, unless he changed.
I believe that was his. I think they're discussing.
They're discussing if the basket went in, but I think that was a borderline displacement. You know, like almost an offensive foul. It can't be a shooting foul because he made the basket.
Yep. Yeah, that'll be four on Matthew Slayton. Caught Brandon Murphy underneath. He's at the line shooting two. All of these guys on their free throws, they look like pros. They look like they've spent hours upon hours just standing there. We're not leaving until we hit 100.
Maybe. We might even hit 100 tonight.
I don't know if we'll get that far, but they probably could if they wanted to.
Right.
But I think Carver's feeling pretty good about their chances. There's Rump looking to Murphy. It's excuse me, that's Houston.
Nice rebound by a blue collar guy.
Here's Lynch taking his time. Guarded by Murphy. Side to Stock. Back up top to Sadorf. D'd up hard by Jarrett. Jack Rubin, floater in.
Nice shot by John.
Good movement.
Yep.
20-point lead for Carver. In the early stages of the third period, here's Houston battling down low, and he's fouled. Deion Sadorf, that's his second. Trojans' third team foul. We sent Demetrius Houston at the line for two. Checking back into the game for Carver is the Auburn-bound Jeremy Johnson.
I think the Carver coach really wants to get these rotations set early in the season. The rotation has been about eight. There's more guys on the bench, but I think the rotation and getting them in the right position in the right places is important.
Stock trying to deal with the press. He's going to get trapped. He's going to get it. They need to get this ball over. Rubin to Lynch. They get it across. They have Blatt down low. Stock trailing up and in. And they beat the trap.
Yep. They did a lot better than they did in the first half.
And they're winning the quarter right now.
Right.
They're down by 21 at the half. And you see Brandon Austin. He's fouled. There's Sadorf picks up his third. Brandon Austin trying to make this a 20-point game again for the Wolverines. I think that's the first free throw I've seen actually hit the rim.
Yep. I think he's the guy with the big follow, the follow dunk that didn't count. He was up there too. Good box out by Wilson.
Rubin, Stock, Lynch. You're gonna get this across, back to Stock. They find Rubin. Got Sadorf on the wing, two-pointer.
Hustling.
Battling for the rebound. Stock gets the rebound, bounces off the front side of the iron. Rumpf with the rebound. They got numbers. Johnson, he's going up and just lays it in once again. Quick gasp from the crowd. They're ready for takeoff. And teams thought there was a timeout there, inadvertent whistle.
I think it's an injury timeout. One of the Wilson players got an elbow.
It's like Philip Blatt caught an elbow in the lip. There you see Jarrett with the steal. Put Carver up by 24. Rump looking down low to Jeremy Johnson, off the glass and in. 19-point game, what was a 19-point game has quickly turned into a 26-point lead for the Wolverines. Looking long for Blatt. He drains it from eight.
Nice pump fake. And you got a turnover here too, so.
Houston trying to find Rumpf on the release and he throws it out of bounds.
Wilson is effective when they break the press in the middle. When they throw the back pass, it doesn't really help them. When they attack in the middle and be aggressive and get a 3-on-2 coming down, they've been pretty successful. Hopefully they can make use of this turnover. Running a flex cut.
It's Sadorf near side to Jack Rubin for three. Hits the front side of the iron. That's no good. Rump saves it. Kicks it back out to Johnson. Carver's off and running. Rump kicking it out to Johnson. Thinks about the three. Driving left. Out to Jarrett. He does take the three. Iron. Nice effort, saving it by Joseph Strug. And we're going back the other way. Stock on the break, off the glass, and in.
Nice take by Stock. He wasn't deterred by the two guys chasing him down. Just went straight up. Good hard-nosed player. I already hurt his finger the other day.
Yes, he did.
I think it was at a dislocation. And
yes, it was.
Popped back in.
Yes.
Hard-nosed guy.
saw it happen. He just ran outside right after that happened. They were yelling for
trainer Beth, to put it back
in. Beth, the trainer, was here, and she went out there. And
I like that he's out there today.
Scrapper.
Right.
Johnson back out to Rump. Near side to Jarrett. Johnson, Rump.
Carver very deliberate in what they want. There's a lot of open shots, but they want to take the things that
Rump
they want
to do. Dishing to Jarrett off the glass down low and in.
Rump is a really nice point guard.
He is. Imagine a lot of these guys can be playing someplace. Yeah. There he is, stolen. Words are still in a bubble over your head, Alan.
All right.
Singing his praises, and there he is with the steal, making it look good. All right. We like players like that.
I do.
Here's Johnson. Three, gets his own rebound off the back iron. And they're going to call him with a personal foul, chase him down. And that's their first foul of the third period. We're nearly 6 minutes in to the second half, and that is Carver's first team foul of the second half. You see Stock, Sadorf, back to Stock.
See, when they break it through the middle, they're very effective.
Right.
Uh-oh.
Carver on the break, Johnson. They know they got numbers. Johnson turning, showing some athleticism, trying to spin it off the glass, and he's fouled.
He made up a lot of space on that drop step. He's up by the free throw line. He made a drop step, and he had a layup.
Call Conklin with the foul, his second, team's fifth. Jeremy Johnson misses the front end of his two. Checking in for Carver's number 25, Caleb Provitt. Johnson converts his second. No. They've been looking good on the free throw. They've missed their last three.
I know. You mentioned you might have put the jinx on them.
Left off the Stock. Guarded by Rump.
Nice pass.
Finds Sadorf on the wing. Baby hook off the front iron. No. Rebounded
nice
by Strug. There's Rump again, pushing it up. He's going to the hole, off the glass, no good. Rebounded by Burkett with the putback. And Carver has doubled up the Trojans. So Portland has a history of good basketball.
Yeah, definitely. The team in the next semifinal, Benson Tech, they're also from Portland or Oregon, right?
Yes, also from Portland, Northeast Portland. They play in the City League. They play some tough teams.
Right.
But you were telling me earlier they have a little bit of a Hawaii tie.
Yeah, they definitely do. Dick Gray, the old coach from Benson Tech, when Gary Gray, his son, played for the University of Hawaii, when their shorts were plaid, Aloha style.
That's right, in the late 70s,
definitely.
I remember him. Him and Gavin Smith were
right.
The players.
Packy Ryan.
That's right. Back in the Larry Little days, the mid-late 70s.
We used to work at camp. He used to come every summer. We used to work at camp. Great camp. Richard Washington came out of Benson Tech along with A.C. Green.
You see Carver holding for the last second shot. We're at 8 seconds remaining. Johnson up top to Rump.
Nice,
they find Strug on the wing, and Burkett with the putback. And we're going to the end of the third period. Carver, the commanding 54-26 lead going into the final period.
This is impressive by Carver. But you have to credit Wilson and the Trojans. They're still battling. I mean, if they can beat this press when they go back home into league, and those types of press might be nothing, you know? You're going to get better for this.
Yes, this is a very good Carver team. If you're just joining us, they are the defending 6A champions, the Alabama.
Well, they look great. I mean, you the guy who just got the last tip in, he's not the tallest guy out there, but he's so active around the hoop that I guess if you're the point guard, you feel comfortable shooting shots up there because, you know, it's maybe probably a pass to one of your offensive rebounders.
Exactly. So if you're the Carver coach, you're up by 26, 28. I mean, what are you telling them? And there you see some of the Carver fans enjoying their stay, sporting the Kukui'nut Lays.
I like that.
Enjoying their time.
I think what would you tell them? You want to just play, you know, I think they're going to different personnel off their bench, looking for different combinations that they might use later in the year. But I think what they did in the first three quarters, they established their press, they established their offense, did a lot of good things. So I think they did what they wanted to do.
We see Austin Blatt getting the and one.
Carver got some new personnel in, so maybe these younger guys can get a chance to play, but also coach is going to be very strict with them and that they run the same type of discipline.
Great way to start for Wilson coming out in the fourth period. Austin Blatt not able to convert the and one.
It's another lane violation called. We had another one earlier.
One of those things they could call more often than they really do if they wanted to. Just kind of depends on the official. You see a new point guard for Carver. This is the point. It's been Zach Rumpf. And we have Caleb Provitt at the point for Carver. Rumpf playing the two now. Long pass to Capitillo. Rumpf thinking about the three. Back to Provitt. He's tripped.
Still hard play out there. Good sportsmanship by the Wilson player picking up the fallen opponent.
You know, he fell hard.
Wilson plays his zone, but their zone is pretty active, so they still put pressure on them.
We have a foul going the other way.
I think they called a traveling on that. He kind of hopped on his step there, didn't really establish a pivot and switched it. They're in a straight man press, but it looks a lot bigger than it is with the athleticism out there.
Watching an interview with Jim Boeheim, the Syracuse coach, a couple of days ago, and he says, you know, the right 2-3 zone looks like a good man-to-man.
Oh, definitely. I mean, he teaches it well. He's a master of the 2-3.
You see Carver on the break. Landy Capitillo pushing the action for the Wolverines. Call personal foul on Sadorf. That's his fourth, seventh team foul for the Trojans. Capitillo will be at the line shooting two. Carver comfortably in the lead, never really been threatened.
I think the game against Marino yesterday, they had some times where the game was a little closer.
Well, I think it was a 10-point game at the half from what I saw, and then it ended up being a 30-point margin, and they just exploded in the second half.
Right. And Marino has some of that size and some athleticism, but I think Carver just has too many weapons.
Some tough defense being played by Capitillo. He strips Austin Blatt. Provitt. Said to Murphy. See Sadorf with the rebound. Conklin bringing it up for the Trojans. Thiessen. Stolen by Dracon Murphy. Oh! Joseph Strug thinking about the dunk, and he couldn't decide what he was going to do and lost his handle.
He was up high. You just hope nobody gets hurt. You know, it's a blowout game. You saw nobody getting injured.
You see Sadorf being marked tightly. Finds Thiessen. Mid-range jumper is good. And Daniel Thiessen.
Nice shot. Got it right out of rhythm.
24-point lead for the Wolverines. We hope all of you stick around for our next game, our second semifinal of the tournament between Benson Tech of Northeast Portland, and there you see the three from Provitt. The second semifinal between Benson Tech of Northeast Portland Punahou Buff and Blue promises to be an entertaining game.
I think it'd be a great game.
Tech's got some length.
They got some length, and Punahou's been playing pretty well.
Well, Punahou has a little bit of size, too.
Yes, they do.
But have Chris Diaz and Byron Mello on the call for that. They will also be calling the final tomorrow. 7:30, Hawaiian time. It's not just Neil Everett that gives the times in Hawaiian.
That's good. I love when Neil Everett does the Hawaiian times. He doesn't forget his old roots, right?
Holds it.
Holds it.
Of course, he's also an Oregon guy.
Great guy.
Yep.
When I was coaching in the late 90s, he was a guy. You know, he had the most talent. We did some interviews with our guys. We loved him. He just took his talent to Sports Center, and we're so proud of him.
Head and shoulders.
Yep.
Head and shoulders. His writing, he was home a few years ago, and I asked him, what served you most? And he says, I can write.
Well, I think was he with HPU? He was with HPU, right?
He was moonlighting.
Yeah.
He was the sports information director at Hawaii Pacific University, and he was also the sports director at KGMB at the time.
Nice.
Wears Magnum style Aloha shirts on air.
Nice. Farmer looking at that short corner look and just not able to finish, but nice look. Best way to beat a 2-3 zone is go to that short corner.
Kick it out, Lynch for a long three, and he frames it. Nice look from
nice
Ben
shot.
Lynch. A 6-foot sophomore, this kid's gonna play. He's only a sophomore. And he's scored a lot of points for the Trojans in this tournament, but a lot of ball handling. See Jaquan Murphy looking for Strug on the far side. We see Philip Blatt checking back in for Wilson and checking in for Carver for the first time. Kendrickus Jackson. Another very tall drink of water, at least by Hawaii standards.
Yep.
Probably be a three man in college.
Probably. Maybe a two.
Maybe a two. About 3.5 minutes remaining this first semifinal in the 41st annual Punahou Invitational Basketball Tournament.
Wilson trying to induce a mismatch. I think they got it.
Stock outside the Lynch. Back up top to Blatt. Is he going to, thinking about the three? Are they going to call the foul? Jaquan Murphy. His first. Carver's third foul in this half. They have 10 fouls this whole game now. 10 fouls.
They play clean. Another three-pointer.
From Lynch. Lynch getting some good looks.
I think in the final, he didn't hit too many three-pointers in that three-point final. He might have saved it for tonight. Maybe he just made a steal, too, so something to end the game on.
There's Blatt blocked by Kendrickus Jackson. It's a 21-point game. Wilson's played them even in this half.
I like their effort. Applaud their effort.
I know, but it's been a very balanced effort from Carver so far. Nobody's really stood out. There's a lot of athletes out there, but no one's really taken the game over.
I think that's their strength. You can't rely on one. You got to do all. Very hard to defend.
Philip Blatt on the wing, being guarded tightly by Jaquan Murphy. Kicks it back out to Lynch. Number of the Wilson players. I think I referred to their shoes as pink. They may be a little orange, coral, little orange pink, little coral colored.
Those are some nice.
Some nice kicks, no doubt about that.
Those are called the Hyper Dunks, but you know they live in Oregon, so.
They got the Nike campus down the street. Lynch hits the front end of the iron.
It's a little fatigue there. A lot of times you play that hard, your shot becomes a little sharp later in the game. Athletic move for a big guy.
We're under 2 minutes remaining in the fourth period. Carver out to a comfortable 21-point lead. Wilson fans behind us wanting the hand check called. Wench is just trying to find his range again. He's like, you know what, you're going to give me a shot from 23 feet. I'm going to take it.
I think Carver's just going to hold the ball. The old monkey in the middle, they got to match up. Probably nice for these officials too. They see different players. They've seen a lot of our local players either in club as they grew up playing. Now they see a different set of mainland players. I think this is good for them as well as officials. They want to move up to the next level, Pac West or something of that nature.
See players move bigger and faster. You see Kendrickus Jackson stealing the rebound. Getting the and one.
Great hustle once again by the Wilson Trojans. Never giving up, never cashed it in. 1.9 in the game, still fighting.
Just over a minute remaining. Carver on their way to another very comfortable tournament win.
The big question is who will challenge them, if they'll be challenged this trip.
They won their first game against St. Francis by 27. They defeated Marino last night by 30. So this is actually one of the closer games. So we're just going to run some clock here. Kinda, who would you single out for Carver if you had to?
I would take that point guard because he set the tone early in the game.
Rumpf.
Yeah, with a couple threes and that drive. That kind of set, that set the old offense because now what do? Pick your poison. You know, I shot a three, come up to me. I'm going to drive by you, and I think he was the little engine that made this team run.
I would have to agree with your assessment, Mr. Lum. Rubin with the rebound, back out to Lynch. He wants to think about another three. There's Blatt with the three off the back iron, gets his own rebound, pulls up from 13.
Nice hustle.
He's going to draw the foul. With 13.7 seconds remaining, he'll get the foul on Kendrickus Jackson, his first.
No quit in these Trojans.
I mean, hey, they're in Hawaii right now, and it's been a little drizzy the last couple days, but it's warm rain. I don't know if you've ever been in Portland in the winter, Alan.
Well, I went to, I had 1 year up at Eugene as my master's, and it was, I enjoyed it. That cloudy weather, it was a little cold, but it was fun. That's before the Ducks became really good in football.
For the University of Nike, and that is the ball game, your final score. Carver High School Wolverines of Montgomery, Alabama, 61. Wilson High School Trojans of Portland, Oregon, 39. Alan, I'm gonna go grab an interview.
Go for it. Hard-fought game. Carver totally dominated. However, you know, we like the Wilson Trojans' effort. They played hard. They got to run a lot of their stuff. Just a little bit more athletic, Carver was. But both teams very young in their season, and hopefully they will go on and do well in their prospective leagues. My guy Mike is down on the floor. He's going to get an interview with our player of the game, who was Zach Rumpf. We're going to go straight to the interview.
All right, we're here with the Carver point guard. You really set the tone early for your team.
What'd you say?
You really set the tone. You seem to set the tone early for your team with a lot of drives.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I just wanted to find my teammates and get them in a position that they can, you know, they score.
Yeah, this game seemed to be a little closer. Most of your point, most of your games so far have been kind of, you know, 30-point blowouts of sorts. What was different about this game for you?
We kind of got it going early, so I was pretty amazed with that.
All right, good. So how are you enjoying your trip to Hawaii so far? It seems like your boys are enjoying it.
Yeah, we having fun right now, man. We just enjoying it out here. Love the environment. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We had beach time last night.
You have a preference as to who you want to see in the finals tomorrow night? You guys are looking really good.
All right. We'll play anybody. We just ready. Yes, sir.
You guys are looking real good.
This is Zach Rumpf, point guard for Carver.
We're wrapping it up from the first semifinal. Carver winning in a blowout, beating the Wilson Trojans. Up next will be our second semifinal, the Pono Buffin Blue versus the Benson Tech. This is the last semifinal, and they'll be called by Chris Diaz and Byron Mello. But I was really pleased and honored to be working with Mike Machado. Want to work with him a little later this year, and I hopefully have that opportunity.
Hopefully, yes, you as well, Alan. This was a lot of fun. I know we're doing a number of basketball webcasts. I think we're doing 3 or 4 doubleheaders. Punavision showing some soccer. I know I'm doing some of the soccer games. Yeah. But, yeah, got a heavy basketball schedule on Punavision thanks to Yuri Biersock and all of his kids. They're doing a great job.
I think Yuri does a great job in getting the kids involved in not only filming, but producing a lot of these productions. And it's also a great archive for these athletes who get to always look back. In our days, we didn't have that. But it's awesome for them. I think they do a great job, and it's also a teaching experience for our kids at Punahou School.
Right, so if you didn't get a chance to, you watch the game live at punahou.edu/webcasts, but if you'd like to watch it again, they archive these games at youtube.com/punavision. So you want to watch this game again, archive it, it'll be there in perpetuity out there in the ether.
Right, you can't tell all the opposing coaches that the games are on YouTube, but they probably find them anyway to scout teams that they don't really have to go to watch them.
That's right, and with that, we will call it an evening, Alan. Thank you for joining us. For Mike Machado and Alan Lum, until next time, have a good one. Aloha.
Aloha.